Washington City Council's now in session. Councilman Mercer, would you please deliver the invocation?
Thank you. Would you join me in prayer, please? Most gracious Heavenly Father, as we come to the end of this beautiful day, we thank you for the many blessings that you've bestowed upon each of us and the citizens of Fair City, Washington. As we gather to discuss the business of our fair city, we ask your guidance, give us the wisdom to do what is right for all of our citizens. We pray for all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let it be known that roll call has been taken silently. All are present, and a quorum is in effect, and the council is prepared to take up the city's business. Okay, new business. Still have a few minutes. Recommended changes to EMS charges.
Thank you, Mayor, members of council. We're on page 146 of your agenda now. The EMS Management and Consultants Incorporated is our consultant that provides us with recommendations based upon EMS charges. You can see on page 147, they're recommended the proposed changes versus the current changes. You can see that the change, there are two changes there. One is the ALS, which is Advanced Life Support Level 2 Emergency Transport. We currently charge nothing for that. The proposed is to increase that to $755.39. And the patient transport mileage charge from $13 to $14. Again, these are recommendations from our contractors, EMS Management and Consultants Incorporated. And it's a recommendation of staff that we adopt said EMS charges.
Well, I just have a simple question.
Manager, I have some reservations. We have a policy, and I appreciate the fact that we can bill the insurance agencies, and those insurance agencies will pay a reasonable charge. Many of our calls are for elderly people, and Medicare allowance is listed here as $401, and that's what Medicare is going to pay. And yet we're recommending that we charge 130% of Medicare. That means that my little old lady neighbor that's 82 years old that may need to go to the hospital is going to be billed at $120 more than Medicare is going to pay. Now, in this case, I know that my neighbor has additional insurance and it's not going to work. But there are many, many of our citizens that are getting by on Medicare. And if Medicare pays the $401, I don't see that we should be dunning that individual for that additional $120 when they have no means of paying it. Now, I appreciate the fact that the 521 is Medicare plus an insurance payment, but if, as I say, many of those people, they're on a marginal income to start with. They're sitting there with a small Social Security check and Medicare. And I know a lady that gets a Social Security check of $686, I think, a month. She can't get supplemental insurance. She has $300 a month of medical prescriptions that she has to buy in order to live. And that leaves her $386 a month to live on. If she needed to call our ambulance and we get her for another $120, she's going to starve to death the rest of the month. And I just have real concerns when we're hitting our elderly population that is already living on what I consider a very minimal income to begin with, and hit them with a bill like this.
Well, unfortunately, Councilman Mercer, somebody has to pay. It's either the individual, the city through Medicaid or Medicare, or the city of Washington. And it appears to me, Mayor, can I ask the manager a couple of questions here?
Please.
Does that include administrative costs? Is that what it is above the Medicare payment? Is that what the cost is?
I'm going to have to call on Robbie.
Okay, Robbie. All right.
And that's really getting out there in the weeds for me too. And all I can do is go off of their advice, because they've been very successful in increasing our revenues in them. We went from about $350,000 a year to close to $500,000. And those guys would be experts in how they collect the money and charge trends. And this is based solely on their recommendation as our billing agency and as a consultant.
Well, would it be a problem for them to give, provide us an explanation before we adopt it?
Certainly.
And I will interject this. Our supplies costs are going up all the time.
I understand.
We're continuing to use a significant amount of more supplies of ALS procedures that we're doing. So we're seeing a steady increase in the supplies that we use as well. But it's our job to provide the care, and you guys can set the rest of it.
Could there be a negotiation between companies to see if we could get a lower rate?
The rates are set back by this body.
Oh, okay. Yes. So we need to lower them, if that's the case.
Well, I'm saying, you know, I think what I would like to see is that our consultant come forward with the breakdown of the cost and see, you know, what the reasonable costs are, and then take the appropriate action. Mm-hmm.
Councilman, it's my understanding, and Chief, correct me, that we pay the collection firm a flat percentage of whatever they collect. And if our fee is the $400 that Medicare approves and they collect the flat $4,100, they're going to get that percentage regardless. If they don't collect that other $120 that sits on the books, they're going to periodically be sending letters to whoever is trying to recur. But they're not. They may not ever get that $120. It's not going to cost them anything other than the fact that they've mailed out bills periodically.
Well, I would still, me personally, if you want to, you know, adopt whatever you're going to do, that's fine. But for me, I'd much rather have a breakdown so I could tell what.
I don't disagree with that.
But what I do know is that how many years ago? 5 years ago, how much money were we losing, Chief? It was substantial. Did you say it was substantial?
Yeah. We were on off $100,000+ because we had not billed for a period of 15 years.
I understand that. But what I'm saying is we're better off now than we were before based on the consulting contract that we have these individuals, and I think we need to take a look at their recommendations.
Well, can I make a recommendation that we table this motion, allow staff to get more information from our consultant on what these price breakdowns are, what our costs are as well, and that way we can come back to you with more information.
Yeah, I think
that was my question. Was what kind of timing are we? We're not up against any kind of contractual deadline or anything.
No. Right?
Okay. Yeah, let's take our time. No reason not to. And Councilman Mercer, I think your point. Unfortunately, that's not unique to Washington, North Carolina.
I understand, but we have an opportunity to address the issue here for our people, and that's what I'd like for us to be very careful in doing.
Well, the thing, now that we're for discussion, the thing that concerned me most of all was that we haven't been charging ALS Level 2 emergency transport. We haven't been charging anything, and yet over here on the proposed is $755.39. And to me, that is a drastic change. If we haven't been charging anything, we're at $755, now that's a big change. I'm not advocating that we don't charge people. I'm just saying, you know, that's a big change.
Okay.
To me, that's more than what we've got up here on the first section.
All right, well, we'll table this until we get some more information.